I'm going to do a 1 minute introduction to Feedly. I've gone to feedly.com, and after I log in, it says cloud.feedly.com, and I'm just going to click on Get Started. So the first thing I see is search for three sites that I love and add them to my Feedly. So to do that, I'm just going to run back to our class, and I'm going to go into our blog forum post, address posts, and I'm just going to highlight the address for Sam's blog and copy it, and then I'll go back to Feedly, and up in this search box I'm going to click on add content, and then I'm going to paste Sam's blog, and it's going to list it here on the side. When I click on it, it will pop up in the window and I can say add to my Feedly. Okay, so now because you haven't got an account yet, you'll have to sign up with Google, and you can use your Gmail account. And we're going to accept this. And it jumped me right in. Now that's because I already had an account. You'll need to put in your Gmail address and your password. And then it'll jump you right in here. And you can see that it says add a new source. It's got Sam's CSE627 blog. You can create a new category. I created one called CSE627 blogs, but you can create it, call it anything you want. Click on Add, and I've now added Sam's blog to my Feedly account. And you can see these are all the blogs I've added. Now, because I forgot to tell it what category to put it in when I put Sam's blog in, it's under the Uncategorized section. So if I go up here and click on Edit, I'll get right back in and I can update it and say I want it in my 627 blogs section. Click Update, and this will take a couple minutes, but it should move. Right, so there's Sam's blog now under my CSE627 blogs. So I can organize anything I find on the web by pulling it into Feedly, putting it in a category, and saving it here. And that's all there is to it.